This is OHSU. Shaped by leaders, pioneers, and those brave enough to take that first step. We carry the torch and shine a light on what is possible. We are a collaboration of disciplines, listening to one another, learning from each other. The OHSU Neurosurgery Residency Program is more than an opportunity to gain experience. It's your time to serve with a community of trailblazers and groundbreakers.
The mission of our neurosurgery residency is to train compassionate, skilled leaders. Neurosurgery is hard intrinsically, and so you've got to love it. You've got to love coming to work. Otherwise, why would we do this? So really what we're looking for is people who come to change things, not just to show up, but to make a difference. And we've been incredibly consistent in turning out that type of resident.
We have a very supportive culture for all of the residents. When you come through, you're never alone. And I think we make a really strong point of that from day one. You develop a bond over time that you really don't get from anyone else other than the people that you're in the trenches with day in and day out. So I think that bond is what makes us all so close.
For me to teach someone else what I've learned and to kind of be able to expand on my experiences and hopefully have people learn from what I've experienced is one of the most rewarding parts of being in academic neurosurgery. I've always felt that the better relationship you have with your faculty, the more you can ask questions, the more you can learn from their experiences, that's really the way that you're gonna learn to be your own neurosurgeon. And so being able to formally teach that is probably one of the most rewarding parts of my job.
The important thing is how the people who train you view your sort of education and capability and their role in that. You know, you have to deal with not just intellectual problems, but problems that are challenging to you psychologically and emotionally. And, you know, it's one thing to sort of be the medical student watching events unfold, and it's another thing to be the sort of fighter in the ring, and that's a completely different experience. Fortunately, I've had, you know, senior level residents, attendings here who have, kind of recognize that they've helped me through strengthening those skills.
What first sparked my interest in neurosurgery was when I was young. I was in grade school, at least about 10 or 11 years old, and there was a neurosurgeon who came to my community. As a child, I didn't really understand the technical aspects or the jargon of what he was doing, but what I did understand is he was doing something really remarkable as a neurosurgeon. He was really using his skill set, his education to help sick children and their families through a very difficult moment in their lives. And that's a lot of what neurosurgery is, right? Patients come to see us and they have these conditions that affect in some ways, the very essence of who they are. It affects their speech, it affects their cognition, it affects their walking. Maybe they're dealing with debilitating pain that impacts their quality of life. And being able to think through, understand what's affecting their lives, develop a plan for them, win their trust, but then execute that plan and hopefully leave them better off after surgery than when you first met them. All of that there is the best part of neurosurgery. It really is seeing somebody after an operation and knowing that you left them better off than when they first came to see you.
In the operating room in the moment, it's all the focus is so intense that it's all thinking about the next technical step and thinking about the resident next to me. How do you want to approach this? Giving the absolute best uncompromised operation to the patient while having that resident step up to the next level of their training.
At OHSU, our operative breadth is very strong. There's almost no aspect of neurosurgery that's not seen here and not encountered by the residents. You know, we may not have the top 2% most rare, the top 2% most common or, you know, straightforward cases, but everything in between, I think we have a large variety of.
At the end of your 7 years of training, you will be a independent, fully trained, fully functional neurosurgeon. Whether that is something that you then move on to participate in an additional clinical fellowship, many of our residents go on to do academic fellowships, or go straight into practice and practice whatever it is that you've chosen as your subspecialty, you will be fully competent and confident to be able to do those things. But it is very rewarding to see someone that you've worked with, that you've taught, go out on their own and hopefully, you know, continue to teach other people and continue to expand our field of neurosurgery.
The most important advice I can give is trust your gut. You know, there's a lot of analytics that go into, you know, this decision for a lot of people, and, you know, medical students are pretty analytically minded, I think, in general. You know, absolutely do your homework, but don't forget how you feel.
What sets us apart is the camaraderie and work ethic, diligence, care for each other that we built during residency. And I think we take that out into the world with our new coworkers and with our new patients, and I think that's what makes a difference.
What makes us great and what makes any individual neurosurgeon great is being really caring of people. And that means not just the patients and their families, but the nurses they work with, each other, making sure everybody is well and balanced and healthy so we can be our best selves for the people around us.
At some point, it's about the why you do what you do as much as the how. We do it because we are bold. We do it because someone needs to make the difference, and we know we can make the difference because we already have. We welcome the curious, inspired, and those willing to be bold. This is OHSU.